You join me at quite an interesting time. Well, interesting for me anyway. This video will be added to the working with YouTube subtitles and closed captions, something I know quite honestly very little about. So this is the video I'm going to be working on. This is why I'm sharing it with everybody, to teach myself and others looking over my shoulder. So in this video, I'll play a bit. Is all about a minute and 6 seconds making a photosphere from a DSLR camera looking like that. There is no speaking in it. The music is provided by The Messenger, which is by Silent Marvel. Like that. So what I want to do is get to grips with how it all works. So there is nothing. How do we get to grips with it? Let's Google examples of closed caption. And I put, and I know something about this square bracket thing that I see, and I put applause in. So a third or fourth or fifth down here, goodness me, down here somewhere. Yeah, look, way down the page is support.google, which is this one. And it says, add your own subtitles, closed captions. The bit I'm interested in learning is number 3. When you get to the part where you want to add something, type it in the box, yada, yada. Sorry, I don't even like saying yada. I don't know why I say it. For example, you can add sounds like applause as applause or thunder, so viewers know what's going in the video. That's what I want to have a go at. And then the most brilliant thing is that, thank you Google, is top result is transcription guidelines for captioning. And it's got this. And I don't know where this comes from. It's just Google has given it to me. It's really useful. So if you go and have a look, and I'll put the link in the description box on this video, how do I format and upload my own? Don't worry about that. The bit that I'm interested in, really interested in, which really is so nice, is transcribe verbatim. And it says ensure you... Yeah, here we go. Let's do the example. Sorry, there's no need to read it. If a speaker says, all right, ladies and gentlemen, if we could get started, please, the transcription would look something like verbatim. Now, the bit I'm interested in, and I know there's no speaking on my video I'm about to look at, but it's quite therapeutic to go through and subtitle your own videos if you're into it, or community source and do other people's as well. The bit I'm really interested, and we can nearly finish this bit, is the one he says, let's do a control F, applause, that'll do. Use this 1.5, use square brackets for non-spoken content. So the example, this is how it looks on screen on the subtitles, or I don't know the difference between subtitles and closed captions. The speaker named Paul throws his chalk, then says, let's take a look at this function. Presume it's something to do with maths. Who knows? Then the transcription, there's two versions, is open the close bracket, type in throws chalk, close bracket. I'm going to use probably this one down here. Throws chalk, closed open. Let's take a look at this function. So in other words, it's telling you how to do it. And here's another one. Children playing. Music. Where's the yellow bike? I left it inaudible. Shouts. Did you see it? Which is really interesting because I believe, obviously as a teacher, that accessibility and equality means everybody should have the access to the information, whether it's seen, listened to, in the style that they're accustomed to best learning. Sometimes people like reading. Sometimes people can't even listen, so they have to read, because they're in a public place or something. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go back, I digress, to my video, and I'm going to add new subtitles, and I'm going to choose English, United Kingdom. Probably because that's the most comfortable one for me. Now this is the bit, and I'm going to do this bit, then stop this video and come back, well, immediately, but for me it might be half an hour. So remember, I've got the video. At the moment, I don't think there is... subtitles on it. I just don't think there is. Actually, good question. Well, there isn't, because I've just come past that screen. Now look, my choices are thrice or three. Upload a file, upload a text transcript, or timed subtitles. I actually don't have one of those. Okay. type or paste in a full transcript of the video and subtitle timings will be set automatically. That's lovely to type it or paste it, but again, I'm a bit squirmy because I don't have one. Number 3, create new subtitles or closed captions. Create subtitles and closed captions by typing them in as you watch the video. That's got to be easy, hasn't it? You know, Bill Gates said, if he did say it, choose a lazy person to do a difficult task because they'll find an easy way of doing it. So I'm going to click that one and see what happens. And it opens up. Boom. Now I'm interested in seeing, let's play a bit. And we're off. There's definitely audio. The audio is music, of course. And I've got some keyboard shortcuts. I've got some help. I'm going to stop this video and I'm going to come back. Well, for you, it'll be immediately when I've filled in a load of this stuff to report back. See you in a second. And we are back again. Now, the interesting thing is it's half an hour later, but I've also worked on this and, let's be honest, been away and got something to eat. So it was all blank and now it isn't blank. So jazz music is playing. A black Nikon D90 DSLR is mounted on a silver tripod taking pictures. Different angles. Jazz music starts to fade away. This is what it looks like. And all we do to drag it around is literally I can drag the little cursor thing around, or the, I don't know what it's called, that red scrub bar. And then all I need to do, I'm not going to do it, I can click and hold and drag left and right and change them. I can also go in here and do the timings. And if I wanted to add something, say, brand new that I'd actually just forgotten, all I need to do is go to the very end. Let's go to the very end. Let's go to there. So let's say I wanted to add something. I don't think I would actually do, but all I would do is I would go up and I would type something and then I would hit enter, and wherever your scrub bar is where it will go. I'm actually quite happy and I'm going to publish this. It was very therapeutic to do it and it's quite nice. It's like you're marking your own work in terms of your video and then adding things into it. I think it's really nice. Let's stop there and get this little bit published and add it to the playlist for working with subtitles, but happy with that.